The devotees had fulfilled his order successfully,
and he was now returning in triumph. Despite the former owner's threat to burn it to the ground rather than see it in the hands of his son, the church has been transformed into a monumental home for Lord Krishna and his devotees. A middle-aged Indian devotee, was instrumental in the purchase, which cost $400,000. Can you guess how much is that doing? Several young Indians, even in a crowded neighborhood, bowed down on the pavement while Prabhupada personally stood, allowing them to touch him. Making his way steadily up the dozen or so stone stairs, unaided except for his cane, Prabhupada entered a wide hallway and then continued to the chapter. Now, in those days, we have been on the temple was cavernous, allowing hundreds to enter darshan.
A mezzanine, that's the balcony floor, replete with steeply banks,
runs around three sides against the back wall. Prabhupada first came as the golden after they can sip of the flower, right from the get-go, Prabhupada talking to the Srila Prabhupada thanked the members of the community. His consciousness of the Prabhupada was more supportive, referring to the two Christian ministers whom he had met with in Detroit the previous year. He stated that the Christian consciousness is the true basis for the United States traditions, because it goes beyond the bodily body. He said that Krishna consciousness, the United Nations have struggled with it for 40 years, but still, there's no growth. Oh. So we have come here in Taranto. So am I right about that? To open this center and give this enlightenment. It is not meant for it is inside. Suppose that we say that we become useful, we become useful. These are not the best. It is made on everyone, isn't it? That is just impersonal. These are the best. So, our, this Krishna consciousness, Mr. Ajit, how to become wise on this Krishna, believe it or not. So we think that we should take this action, this is the platform of the United Nations. We're united within each, and we are not
single minded. This sounds like finished.
Volumes of books. We have already published about 54 books. These books are selling very nicely. It is not something, it is a science. So, request the people of this nice city, Toronto, to take advantage of this movement. Come here, read our books, make your questions solved, and you'll be all happy. It doesn't matter whether you are Canadian, or Indian. It doesn't matter. Thank you very much. All right. He asked for questions, but there were none. Mr. Carmichael will then escort him amongst the rescue quarters, which are at the side of the future. Consists of a reasonably sized sitting room, called a sitting room, and a small bedroom with attached bathroom, usually a bathroom. It also has some, by the way, it also has some offices next to one of our islands. Mr. Krishna Maharaj reorganized for one of us. We will bring in a more suitable guest. I ran around some lines to the end of the Prabhupada relaxed and allowed some weight to the devotees to enter the large plate of the opera shop. And after tasting the horse, he handed out small portions. This is no one's. Leaning back against the cushions and the last year when I prayed to Krishna, let us have these two places. Give us a lot of time for Krishna's sake. Everyone laughed in pleasure because intimate connection. They were trying to do something specific with Krishna's desires and reactions. According to one of the movies, construction has been described in 1896 as a miracle. Even though it is mid-June, until the sun comes up again, it's going to be until we walk in front of the although the Indian community in Toronto has been defensive, so far they have not shown much support at this point. This morning, Polish one of the Indian so true. What happens is the immigrants come, they give themselves a status, and then they get and I know that I'm talking to Mr. Maharaj.
Yes?
Yes. So,
yeah.
What do you want, Sam? Okay, Srila Prabhupada told him that India is indeed the land of God, but the people of India are not following God's instructions. He gave the example of this. Hari Bol, how are you? Happy I'm here at the beach. How can I help you? Raj, okay, here you go. He's right here.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Okay, if a policeman is coming up to the street, where is the best? So in Bombay they canceled their temple sanctuary. So care temple sanctuary. And they said something from the givers in Bombay. They run this
place.
And these politicians are having to do see this. What else is the business of Guru? Guru will not say anything new. Just like a child, by reading a book, he will not understand. So he understands. But Guru is one. Today, son of a big guy has become Guru. And he is showing magic. And he goes, Bhagavan! This son of a big has done everything wrong. This is what has happened. You show magic and you have many disciples. But when they say, the Bhagavad Bhajan, give up meat and eggs, that they will not accept. The person who will show wrong path and will show magic for going to hell, he is with them. This is what has been done wrong. He will broadcast Bhagavad Gita and he will kill Krishna. He is Paka at present. So Prabhupada's being very sarcastic here and just saying that there's a lot of people coming across as Guru, some people. Where did that be? Underwater.
guys in this Guru Maharaj gym, and he had a big following worldwide, and he would dress up like Krishna. So people are gullible, and they fell for him. Then his mother declared, no, he's not Krishna. It's my other son who is Krishna. So it's like, talk about double confusion, right?
Yep.
Okay. So we got some good stuff here. Any questions so far? What time is it?
8:20, sir.
8:30. Okay, good. We'll just do a little bit more.
He paraphrased a Mayavadi who had written that Krishna was a black man who had been killed by Bhagavan.
They are broadcasting like this, and the foolish accepted this. You are in a foreign country. Try to understand the word. This is the teaching of Mother Parish. This temple has been opened. Are the Bharatiya people coming to the temple? How many times? 50. See how long it is. Okay. So that's one little section. We have another thing to do. Alright? Yeah. Yeah, that's true. We have about 15 people from India, maybe in the temple. The rest of us were young boys and girls living in the temple at that time. Most of us were not married. But then that next year, we got the big building. A lot of marriages took place. I was But I remember Srila Prabhupada, one afternoon, and we were in the basement, and like where the conference room was, and Vishnu got the temple president. I knew he was going to ask him, to get married. So he started to talk to me, and he said, so Bhaktivinoda, he says, I just come out and talk about something that Prabhupada would do. And then so, Vishwakarma, and he just got distracted. He never got that joke. I knew it was going on because everyone was, a lot of the girls in the temple, they were matching up everybody. Oh, so-and-so can do it. There was a little bit, because everybody was there, right? And so that kind of thing was happening at the time. So I got spared. I didn't get it. I had my connection to this particular role.
We're very lucky.
but most of you will settle down and get married. And maybe she was. And yesterday, Shirley was with me and I said about relationships. And it's been heart touching.
One thing I'll say, Mark, Marj brought my wife and I together, and one of the things I learned from Marj is always keep Krishna at the center.
Okay, we'll finish up here, guys. Not too many conversations.
I'll say one thing I learned from Marj is always keep Krishna at the center of your relationship. Right, and always act with your spouse the way you would as a Prabhupada's in the room. And there's no reason to raise your voice or sort of differences. So that's one thing I learned from the Maharaj. It was a good science or a formula for us at the time. So,
We had another question here. Would you like to ask it?
Oh, yes,
I think
so. I asked him.
Is that okay?
Yeah, no. I would love to hear your thoughts on it. So, on the way here, I was thinking about what we get and what we give in life. I mostly feel responsible for the things that I feel responsible for with my family, friends, cooking, celebrate my birthday, to give the celebration back. I feel like this is a very, very in my mind. So, I'm trying to balance. not feel it, or do I want to? Yes, because do I want to do it because of my control, to satisfy myself? And at what point did you learn when it comes to that feeling service is one thing, but I don't know about emotions by my mom. That's why I'm working too hard. I want to make her happy, but if I do that, I have to do what was happening to
Well, if you're trying to do something for someone else, so like you're talking about your mother, that's not selfish. It's not selfish. Just what you have to do is, for any one of us who have arrived and do something, achieve something, accomplish something physically, it's not bad necessarily, but you don't want to kill yourself in the process. You want to get to the balance. That's why in the morning, just I'm talking about practically, in the morning you do some devotional things. Those steps are real simple and easy. They're not that complicated. Like in our conversation, we said, well, prayer is a good idea. Or with puja, or with worship, some chant, just even a half hour to make a whole difference. So that's half an hour of 1 hour. It's a good investment. Start off. So that's what we recommend. You do have to, while you're doing all these prayers, you have to do something else. Your God sign. So you don't want to neglect the last part for the sake of everything. So do take care of your spiritual needs. And a beautiful example is that Prabhupada, just like saying, this is a good. But let's say it's a bird cage, and you can see from it, and there's a canary in there, canaries there, yellow or whatever. And, you know, you take care of the cage, meanwhile, you let the bird start. It doesn't make any sense. You're looking at the exterior, and this, you know, superior living in the center, offering so much goodness. So much joy, and you don't necessarily have to do it. So it's a little bit like that. You put a lot of investment in your material needs, but then there has to be some kind of, let's say, balance, and some investment towards your soul. So that's what we call that balance, sadhana. Sadhana in the morning, like it's like a spiritual workout. Work on good to take care of their physical self, but I bet you most of them are not invested in their spiritual self, which is the essence of what we are. We're not the physical being, we're spiritual. So I would just reflect on this. Three times a day, you know, put some punches in there. Noontime as well. And move with the sun a little bit. Before the sun comes out, jam some spiritual energy. The sun is out. You know, the presence of God as well. It's his eye. It's Krishna's eye. His eyeball. He's got his eyes on all of us. So when high noon, it's a good time to have some reflection here, and also on the for the working. Now when you join the program of the Academy, it's a little more full on the spiritual stuff. Some of you know the schools and all that's great. But we're spending the morning in spiritual endeavors. So that's the purpose of the practice. Yeah,
observe some body there, body there, so it's not terribly selfish, it's natural. It's called the Bhakti. So, like what Cheru was talking about yesterday, the love is cheap when it's just sort of immediate and like spurty, but when it actually is takes time to come, that's what the love takes time for, that reciprocation. So I think we should get started, right? Is it offered?
Yes.
Okay, great. I don't want the chips, but I'll take everything else.
Looking good.
Yeah, looking. Thank you.
Thank you.
Today it is your job to deliver my call. Keep it for me. It's my Sunday. We can use just washing hands.